Dad wrote sometimes, giving news about the family, and Tommy and Jane visited once. Tommy hugged me awkwardly and kept telling me how it was safe for me to come home. "I can't, Tom," I told him. "This is my home now." My 16th birthday was getting closer, the age at which I could make some of my own decisions. Leave school, get a job, live where I wanted to. I sometimes took the bus, communed with the trees in Cornwall Park and sometimes the bush or wild beaches out west. I never felt afraid. Even here the birds came close. They were fewer in number than in the great northern forests. The trees still settled my heartache, and occasionally, in the supermarket or just walking down the road, I smelled the dirty clay of death. Despite everything, my gifts had not deserted me. Sometimes I wished they would. They reminded me of the place I had left. They reminded me that this was not where my heart truly lived. 20. Missing Mila, Pūketi Forest. Tommy missed Mila very much. He listened to Tama and Esther and Kath and Grandma talking about her. He knew that the adults were all blaming each other for her leaving. He was very sad she'd run away. He'd seen her in the forest on the crazy day before she left, but while he could see that she was upset, he didn't guess she still felt unsafe. He had his own stuff to worry about that day. If he'd known that she was going to take off, he would have been clearer. There was nothing here to hurt her now. He was there, he knew. Tommy was good at keeping a secret. There were thousands and millions of them in the forest. Mila's hut was a secret, and he would have to look after it for her now, so that when she came back it felt like new.